Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, hi, my name is Mimi. If you are a follower for a while, then you know that I used to use Khadi Natural hair care products all the time before. And if you have noticed, then you know that I don't use Khadi Natural products any longer, and that's why I don't mention them here on my channel. So in today's video, I'm gonna share with you why I don't use Khadi Natural hair care products any longer. So if you guys wanna know more about it, then continue watching. So back at the time when my hair was shorter, like tailbone length or even shorter than that, Khadi Natural was my go-to. I used to use majorly Khadi Natural hair care products on my hair, and I have only used their hair oils and shampoos on my hair, and also their indigo powder. So Khadi Natural was the main thing, that main brand that I used to use back at the time. I used to use other products too, but mostly Khadi Natural. I have a couple of reasons why I don't use Khadi Natural products any longer. So the first thing is, if you look up their products online, like their official website or other websites where Khadi Natural products are available, you will see, and you if you go to the oil section, you will see a bunch of different hair oils. Like they have their Amla hair oil, a Bhringraj one, a Rita one, an 18 herbs one, a vitalizing hair oil, and the list goes on and on. And I have used almost the entire list of their hair oils. So all of these hair oils, they have one key ingredient and 4 to 5 other ingredients in them. So all of these herbs which I mentioned, like Amla, Rita, Shikakai, Bhringraj, all of these herbs are really essential for your hair. And if your aim is to grow your hair longer, then you need to add all of these essential herbs to your hair care routine. So that's the reason why back at the time I bought those hair oils one after the another, and I started using them on my hair. So if you want to grow your hair, you're gonna need all of these herbs, or most of these herbs. So buying like 8 to 10 hair oils isn't like cost effective, I would say, because it adds up to like 1,000 to 1,200 rupees, where you can get all of those herbs, all of those essential herbs in one hair oil, which I currently use, and I'm talking about the AVS Kotakal one. So from Amla, Bhringraj, Shikakai, Rita, Indigo, the list goes on. You get all of those essential herbs in one oil. So I would buy one oil than 10 different variety of oils. So yeah, that's also waste of money and waste of my vanity space. So that's the first reason why I stopped using Khadi hair oils. Now let's talk about the shampoos. From Khadi, I have used few of their shampoos. Like I used to use the Amla and Bhringraj one. That was my go-to shampoo back at the time. Apart from that one, also I have used the Rita one and also the Honey and Tulsi one. So the Amla and Bhringraj one, as I mentioned, it was my go-to shampoo because it's so good for people with oily scalp, and especially during summer months, it cleanses your hair and scalp so nicely. But I used to use it mostly during summer, and throughout the other time of the year, I didn't found myself reaching out for the Khadi shampoos at all, because you have to be really careful while using Khadi shampoos, because if you use a little bit extra, it can dry out your hair, and to compensate that, you'll have to use a lot of hair mask or conditioner on your hair. So like during the other time of the year, monsoon, winter, I used to have like half of the bottle left with me, which I think was like a waste of the product. So that's why I stopped using the Khadi shampoos. And also I found other alternative shampoos which are natural, sulfate free, and also you can use them throughout the year, no matter the season. The final reason is they also changed their packaging. If you have noticed, now I don't have any issue with them changing their packaging, but I think there is a little bit change in the ingredient list as well, because back at the time when I started using Khadi, I mainly started using Khadi Natural is because of their ingredient list. Because I was searching by ingredients like Amla, Bhringraj. I was searching by ingredients online, and in the ingredient list of Khadi Natural, always the key ingredient which is mentioned in the front of the packaging in the ingredient list, it is that ingredient always used to be at the top. It was either the first ingredient or among the first two or three ingredients. So that's the reason why I mainly started using Khadi Natural back at the time. But now, after they changed their packaging, if you look at it, I don't know if it is with all of the POC products, but in a few products I have seen that the key ingredient is a bit down on the ingredient list, like the key ingredients which is mentioned in the front of the packaging. If you look back at the ingredient list, it's like down to the sixth or seventh ingredient on the list, which personally I don't approve, because I won't put my money in a product where the key ingredient is like the sixth or the seventh ingredient in the ingredient list. So that's why I'm not gonna use the newer Khadi Natural's newer packaging and the newer products. So this is why I don't use Khadi Natural hair care products any longer. I still use the indigo powder, but the shampoos and the hair oils I don't use any longer. And also, to be specific, I only used Khadi Natural back at the time. I haven't ever tried Khadi Maurya, Khadi India, Vadi or any other brands. So let me know in the comments down below if you still use Khadi Natural hair care products, or you used to use Khadi Natural hair care products, if you have tried any of their products with the newer packaging, if you see any difference or not. I'd love to know that. Let me know in the comments down below, and also give this video a thumbs up if you liked it, and subscribe to my channel for more videos. And I'll talk to you guys later soon with another video. Till then, bye.